Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to discuss about headings and paragraphs used in HTML. Before starting, you can note my information, which includes my app, books and YouTube channel. So coming on to the topic, first I am going to explain about headings. So as you can see here, headings starts from H1 and it ends to H6, and you can implement all the headings by following this example. So here H1, H2 and H3 headings are implemented. Now I am moving to Notepad to implement all these headings. So you can see this example here. First, a doctype HTML version of HTML is written. Then I have implemented head tag. Inside head, I have implemented title tag, which will show page title content on title bar of the browser. Then body tag is implemented. Inside body, I have implemented H1 tag. Now I have to make 6 copies of it. So I'm copying it and I'm pasting it 6 times. Now I have to convert these headings starting from H1 to H6. So this way I have converted all H1 into H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6 headings. So now I am going to save this code. So I am pressing Ctrl S, as this program is already saved in my computer. So I have converted this slide in this program. Now this program is saved in this HTML folder with first.html file name. So now I am going to double click this file. So this file is opened in Opera web browser. So you can see the output. H1 is showing larger text than H2, smaller than H3, more smaller than H4, then H5 and then H6. So all these headings are predefined, and their formattings are also predefined. So there are 6 variations which you can use to display contents on web browsers. So now again I am coming on to the slides. So I have explained the headings. Now coming on to the paragraph. So another variation is paragraph, which you can implement with the help of p tag. So you can see these examples. I have implemented 2 paragraphs using p tag. First is containing this is a paragraph, and second one is containing this is another paragraph. So as I have demonstrated various headings which showed different font size while printing the text, but in case of paragraph we use same p tag. So if we use p tag twice or thrice, output will be in same font size. It will not be different from each other. So now I am going to demonstrate this to you. So I am removing all these headings. So I am typing first paragraph. And then second paragraph. So I have implemented 2 paragraphs. After completion of typing, I have pressed Ctrl S. Now again, I'm going to web browser. So see, I have updated my Notepad file. Now, every time you don't have to open that file by double clicking. If this file is already opened in web browser, you can simply refresh your web browser. So I have refreshed with this button, which reloads the HTML page which is saved in your computer. You can also press F5 to refresh your web page. So you can see the output. This is a paragraph and this is another paragraph. 2 statements are printed with the help of p tag. So I have used p paragraph tag twice, so that's why 2 different statements are printed here. Now p tag contains an attribute which is known as title attribute. So you can see this example here. P tag is containing title about HTML, and it is containing a text. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. It is used to design web pages. So you have to read this note. When you move the mouse over the element, the title will be displayed as a tooltip. So this title attribute is used to show tooltip for paragraph. So now I am going to show how you can implement this tooltip. So I have modified first paragraph's title as about HTML, and now I am pressing Ctrl S to save this. Now I have to open my web browser, and I am going to press F5. So as I pressed F5, my page is refreshed. Now I am taking the mouse on. This is a paragraph. So you can see about HTML is displayed as tooltip. If I take my mouse on, this is another paragraph. Nothing is displayed because I have attached tooltip with first paragraph. So with the help of this title attribute, I can implement the feature of tooltip. Now comes single or double quotes. So right now I have implemented title attribute and P tag. So you have to notice that if you want to display some text in double quotes, like shotgun is displayed here, so you have to enclose the whole string in single quotes. And if you want to print the text in single quotes, then you have to enclose the string in double quotes. So this is vice versa. So you have to focus on this feature of HTML that belongs to single quotes and double quotes. So implement all this demonstration in your laptop. I have explained you headings and paragraph tags. So you can implement this these tags in your laptop so that you can understand the working of both the tags. Thank you for watching this video.